Hey guys, Ravi here. You might have heard about the ESP8266. These are Wi-Fi enabled modules that can run Arduino sketches. They are cheap, they are fast, they are small, and have been tremendously successful in the IoT community. Some time ago, their successor was launched, the ESP32. Now, the nonsensical naming scheme aside, it has everything you could ever want from a microcontroller and then some. Dual core microprocessor, biggest memory, Wi-Fi, Bluetooth 4.2, built-in touch sensors, I2C, SPI, the list just goes on. But just because it has the hardware doesn't mean that it can use every potential feature. As of making of this video, the software support for the device is still very much in development. Especially the support for Bluetooth. You can't create services for BLE, you can't use it as a Bluetooth host, basically you can't do shit with the Bluetooth part of this thing. But regardless of the official software support, I have figured out a way around its non-existent libraries. This video is going to have two parts, the example build and the explanation. Because you guys might want to do this with different hardware, or you just might want to use the communication part of this project. For the example build, I am going to make this portable temperature sensor that will send the temperature to your phone over BLE. So let's get building. The only hardware you need is an ESP32 based board and a digital temperature sensor. Since my board supports the external battery, I'll be using this 3.7 volt LiPo that I salvaged from an old media player. I'm sticking everything on a styrofoam disc, which acts as an insulator for glasses of beverages and enables me to bring the extra length of wires into some semblance of order. The connections for the temperature sensor are pretty simple. Red to 3.3 volt, brown to ground, and the data pin to GPIO2, which on my board is marked as D9. You do need a 4.7 kilo ohm resistor between the data pin and VCC. But I got this 3-pin terminal with my temperature sensor, which has a built-in pull-up resistor. For the software, download and install the Arduino IDE. Download the board files from the link in the description and unzip them to this location. In the Arduino software, go to Sketch, Include Library, Manage Libraries, and search and install the OneWire library. That done, download the code from the description and open the file named Temperature Example. Plug in your ESP board, select the correct board and port from under Tools and hit Upload. Now all that's left is to get the companion app and click start scanning. That's the project done. But if you're wondering how I am sending this data without the library support being there, this is how. If you thought that I have actually gone into the SDK and written a new library to bring the BLE support for creating services, then you would be bitterly disappointed. What I have actually done is essentially jerry-rigged the software on both sides. The simple BLE library doesn't yet have support for creating services, but it does let you create a BLE beacon even though nothing can connect to it. What my code does is that it keeps changing the beacon name itself, which contains the data. The name always has the same prefix, so the app can identify the ESP. I made the app using the MIT App Inventor, and what it does is pretty simple. It looks for all the BLE devices in its vicinity, and when it finds a device name with the predefined prefix, it splices the name and displays the data from the end. And that's how simple it really is. I'll have a second code file named template, which you can use as a base to write your own code to send all kinds of data and not just temperature. The app is generic and would work with that code too. Also, the project file for the app itself will be available to you to mess around with yourself. This video was made possible by dfrobot.com. A huge thank you to them for sending me their Fire Beetle board and the temperature sensor. Check them out for your next project, they send stuff in a really nice box. I hope you liked this video. If you did, hit that like button, leave a comment telling me how horrible my code is, and subscribe for more projects coming soon.